for the next few months. I will almost every Saturday be coming by here at least until the middle of May, because inside this enclosure we have Trillium. Trillium is T-R-I as in three. It is a plant that grows with three petals, three sepals, three leaves, three stamens and six pistils, or the other way around. I can't remember that part right now. They are not exactly rare, but they are unusual to find in the woods. A big factor in that is the excessive deer population and the fact that the second name for Trillium ought to be deer candy. The deer love to wait until the seeds are forming and plump and juicy, and they come and eat the entire seed pods. Marf, gone. So when I first began dealing with this, there up in the far corner there was no more than 12 plants rather, in two little groups very close together. I managed to get a circle of wire, much like what you see over there at the bottom of that little tree, around them. And lo and behold, the deer couldn't eat the seed pods. They seeded in and we started to get some reproduction out of them. After a couple of years, it was apparent that we were getting very good reproduction out of them and we needed to do better. So I put up this enclosure out here. So in early May, maybe depends on the weather, but probably early May, this entire enclosure will be wall to wall Trillium. And they will fruit out, seed in, and what happens is some of the seeds spill or wash down into this zone right in here, and we get infant Trillium down in here. Because we've been at this for a while, they have started to grow over in here. So we actually have mature Trillium in this area, basically from that tree up to that little tree right in there, that are now seeding in as well. So we get good reproduction in here. As we move into the season, I will probably get some help and we'll go and grab a few branches and we just litter this area with branches because the deer don't want to get stuck in there, walking in among a bunch of stuff in case they've got to break and run. So that discourages them from getting here in here and eating the Trillium that are not protected. The Trillium also run from here two-thirds to three-quarters of the way back to that blazed tree. So we've done very well in here with this. Trillium are intriguing in many ways. They can grow as densely as to be a complete ground cover sort of a thing, but they are a spring ephemeral, so they have a short period of time to operate. So sometime in the next couple of weeks, we'll start to see some growth in there. And then by mid-May, most of them will have been pollinated and either have developed or will be developing seeds at that point. And then when that's all finished, they will disappear until the following springtime. They have a partnership with ants. It's Myrmeca something, or Myrmeca means ant-related thing. And what they have with the ants is an agreement. We will supply you ants with the tastiest darn thing you have ever come upon if you'll carry our seeds around. So Trillium seeds actually grow. They have a little seam on them, and on that seam there will be a little white, fatty, sugary deposit. It's almost as if it's squeezed out of the seam. I don't know if that's how it happens or not. But anyway, that is irresistible to ants. And so the ants, what's that on, what's that I smell? They go, they pick up the Trillium seed, they carry it back to their ant mound, they get it back to the ant mound, and the way I usually describe it is, the guy who's watching the door says, where are you going with that thing? Why, it smells great, it tastes great, I brought it home. It's not gonna fit through the door. You can't bring that in here, it's just too big. So they take the little treat off, which may have to look that up. There are two different names for it. Both are applicable, and I can't remember it right now. But they peel off the goodie, and they kick the seed over the hill into the trash pile. Well, almost everything outside an ant mound is trash pile. It's the dirt that they've dug up in there, and they are fastidious. Dead ants, invading insects, you know, loose bits of dirt, grass, or whatever down, and they bring it out, and that's why you get an ant mound. That's what it is. It's the, you know, leftovers and trash from their tunneling around, and so they take that down in, and they're happy as can be. And the Trillium has been looking for the soil from an ant mound to seed into, because that's the perfect soil for a Trillium. So what we see back here in this little circle, there is a Trillium nursery there. There was an ant mound there. And 2 years ago, I came out and found that, and holy smokes, it might have been 3 years ago now, there was a solid circle of minute baby Trillium growing there. So I've got to do something about this, so I put that circle of fence up. Last year, I was planning to come out and start transplanting some of those baby Trillium farther out and around in here, and COVID hit. And they shut us down completely. So during the Trillium transplant season, I wasn't even allowed to come out to the Arboretum. So it got away. Well, what that means likely is they were so tight and crowded in there that by now Darwinian stuff has happened, so some of them are gonna have been lost as others got strong enough to kick the, you know, beat up on the ones next to them. So we'll see when that comes up. But that's what that little circle is. Overt evidence that there was an ant mound right there. Trillium, as I say, it's three parts of three parts and three parts kind of a thing, but not until they are teenagers. The first year when a Trillium seed hits the ground after this season, you know, sometime late, well, let's call it June just to give it a buffer time. When that seed hits the ground in June, it will germinate and it will put out its taproot. And that's all it will do until the following spring. So it puts out its taproot and it lays there on the top of the soil. Well, that little seed and that little taproot are kind of tender. You step on it, you squish the taproot, you've killed that Trillium. It's going no farther. The following year then, when it does start up and you look at it, it's a single puny little leaf, looks like a small grass leaf. And then for several years it grows looking like a grass leaf that's putting on weight, until after several years you come out and you look, and now all of a sudden it takes a spoon shape. And then it does the spoon shape for 2-3 years, whatever it happens to be. It's highly variable. Depends on the species of the Trillium you're dealing with, weather conditions, you know, whether you've sprinkled magic fairy dust on it, who knows what, you know, what's involved in it. But anyway, it does this spoon leaf for a number of years, and then finally you come out and you look, oh my goodness, look, it's a little Trillium, because finally it's showing three leaves and people can recognize it who don't know any better. But it's going to be a little tiny Trillium. And then it is going to gain strength and gather strength and, you know, get bigger and bigger. So that little Trillium that's, you know, a circle of three leaves, that's maybe, you know, total of that with all three leaves showing, gets to be something that's about that diameter, where the leaves are broad and the edges touch one another all the way around, and a nice big Trillium flower off. First few years they are basically unidentifiable and very fragile. Then they finally get to the point where you can tell what's going on, and they're still rather fragile because it's a small plant, and in order to flower and fruit it has to be big and bold and strong, you know, good root structure, all of that. So it takes a while for a Trillium to happen. So Trillium, the ones that we have here, we're not sure where they came from. What we do know is that they are a cross of some sort. It's quite likely a natural cross, but we still don't know where they came from. But as Trillium go, these are on steroids. These do everything pretty rapidly. So these are probably maturing within about 10 years. So that cycle of, you know, spending time as a single leaf, spending time as a spoon, you know, all seems to be compressed and operating at high speed for these, which is why they're starting to spread out for us. And we're perfectly happy with that. You would have to have them genetically analyzed to possibly figure out what the cross is. But they're a great plant. If you get the chance to come out here anytime between now and the middle of May, this, you know, you come and look and see what's going on, and you just stay on the pathway for us.